5 p.m.
Yes.
Esports.
I got up early for this.
Oh, cannons. Go! Cannons coming here. Spear lands max range. That's an immediate cleanse. And I guess that's why he took the cleanse, guys. Cleanse plus Nimbus Cloak gets him all the way out of there.
And how you can avoid, you know, CC and stuff like that as, ooh, that's really unfortunate for Cuz.
Exactly. Cannon not going to have Vault to disengage from Haru here. Misses the blind and has to flash. But Cuz is going to be set up. Harrier comes down, actually, as there's the Facebreaker. Immediate flash out there from Haru as double teleports are coming in. They're still going in on a Dudu, a phenomenal bubble. As Miru now in trouble, actually, as soon as he comes down. Just a lot of DPS with these members of T1, but no one to go down just yet.
Haven't seen the Ruthless Predator interaction, which I want to see. So
this Faker comes down with an Ignite in hand. Haru, Battlestar's going to miss, though, as now Effort taking so much damage. Flashes out of the way, as there's the Haymaker from Cuz, keeping him alive. Teddy avoiding so many of these skill shots. His Magical Journey has to get Hanwha away from this one. Cuz, still around, will have the smite available, and that is Ocean Drake. Secured for T1, Faker still.
Yeah, once again, it's like, let's play for Viper.
Yeah.
Let's give Viper everything that he wants, I suppose.
Well, in goes the Galio. That's a great depth charge as Faker's gonna flash out of the way of everything right there. Miru, obviously, much bigger brain than we were expecting. Viper, I don't know how he landed that Mystic Shot, but he did. Faker gonna have to go back, but does have teleport.
We'll have to wait and see how this fight goes.
Yep. Quinn is to the skies at the moment as Effort may have to flash here. He's going to go golden first, holding out his anchor, looking majestic, flashes away. Now Faker getting engaged on here by Miru, who finds one taunt onto Cuz, but he's pretty tanky. Will have Haymaker available. Keep himself alive. 18 minutes and 20 seconds into the game, guys. This will be our latest first blood, but can they bring the record further? No! They won't be able to as Faker's going to be taken down. Humble line, claim first blood at 18 minutes and 25 seconds.
Quinn. We'll see what Ken is going to build next. Not going to need a QSS or anything like that here. This game is, yeah, very frustrating for this Renekton to deal with the Quinn.
Yeah. Renekton's... Okay.
We're looking for it, but has to use the flash and the cleanse as that lifeline passive ended immediately.
Yeah, I just kind of got my face in my hands here because this is where... This is where Quinn is supposed to be the strongest, right? Renekton,
yeah.
Very strong in the beginning with the support of the Nidalee, the two-on-one, the winning the lane, right? They kind of did put on a lot of pressure, and Renekton got a bunch of items.
Well, if at first you don't succeed, as there's the vault, slice back in, Dudu just kills him.
I don't know what is going on here, man. That is just, again, a lack of respect of what the Renekton can do. You're super low, and Renekton can close the distance. They're looking to try to turn it around, though.
Yep, Miru gonna be in trouble here. Facebreaker comes in. Faker wanting to chase him down. Doesn't find the portal jumpers. Okay. Faker's gonna go golden, but Dudu has made his way in. Faker gets out. Cuz may not be so lucky. Haymaker, fair bit of damage. Both of them get inside the Tempered Fate. It's a golden cuddle just to make sure that they survive. Lahens to the rescue. He's gonna take a Magical Journey, trying to find the Sun on Effort. Doesn't get there though. Can't make the connection. Miru trying to justice punch forward and Hum alive on the attack. As there's the dredge line onto Miru, but that may not be the re-engage that you want, T1. Haru dives on in, finds the pounce onto Faker, who makes it underneath his turret. Low health bars as Kanna's gonna come in to make this a 5v5.
As we have another fight here.
We'll see whether this is gonna be T1's first kill as Lahens actually gets dredge lined into his Tempered Fate. It's not going to actually do anything, as that's the first kill for T1. Fair bit of damage onto Faker, otherwise not too much. Kanna getting rid of that inner turret as Faker portal jumping forward. What is going on with the mid laner of T1 here today? As Featherstorm comes out, there's the showstopper onto Miru, who goes golden into that backline. He will fall down as now Kanna makes his entrance. That's a couple of kills. Dredge line's beautiful from Effort as well. As Lahens goes down and Effort is able to survive. Summoner spells, grabs his flashback again. That's all right. Here's the showstopper into the back line. Cuz joining Dudu there as Viper. Still at half health, feeling all right. That's a huge ultimate out of the Ezreal. Effort's going to get ripped apart. The Quinn died somewhere in there as well. Renekton grabs one kill. Beautiful timing there on the Justice Punch. And Humble Life smash T1 in the face. But it looks like Humble Life, they think they can do it. They've got a minion wave coming in. Faker, I don't know what he can actually do about this. He's got a broken stopwatch and nothing else, as we do have Nautilus respawning with the first Nexus turret. Is going to go down. The second now is in trouble as Viper's getting out of the way of effort where he can. Teddy and Cuz are going to respawn, but the Nexus is being focused, and Humble Life will take game one against T1.
Before it did start the game, as here we're going to take another look at Kana's point of view.
Oh, he went aggressive.
Ooh, the second slice in there.
Oh, canceled a few autos there as well.
Yeah, so Renekton is really good at
so far being out of control.
And I want to shout out to our good friend.
All right, in goes Cuz. Mirror should be dead here. He flashes. That was never going to work out. Dredgeline onto Effort, who has picked up turret aggro. And, able to flash at the very end. Is now Faker. Has to deal with Dudu, as that Q from Haru was utterly stunning in this game.
Weird.
Yeah. Focused Will here from Miru, unable to proc the snare on Cuz.
Lahens is just going to waddle his way up, but Effort's here as well. Dredgeline to try and get Lahens out. Hookshot doesn't get the stun, but there's the Hextech ultimatum as Miru stays alive for a long time, but eventually will suffer his second death. Humble Life, stealing all of the crockery on the bottom side of the map.
The first split turret pull.
The Dominus out of Dudu, and that is a shorter trade. That's what we were talking about, but it's ultimate on cooldown. Now possible danger here as Faker.
He knows it.
Oh no. Yeah. And there's also going to be a Pantheon as Kanna has found it. And he's going to be able to lock down the kill.
Okay, Gravidim's going to land. Max range dredge line there from Lahens, but Effort going to keep himself safe as Haru Viper kickback onto the Ash. Absolutely amazing. Moonlight Vigil comes down now as it's Viper's time to shine. The only AD carry left. Somehow Dudu lives through the power of, you know, just having Q and also the Inspire Shield. And this should be the first Infernal going over to Hanwha if they have the confidence. Looks like they don't, as Faker's got a lot of flashes to pick up. Finds a bubble onto the Aphelios, but no follow-up here as Lahens is going to block the Paddle Star. An Effort. He's got the Grand Skyfall very, very soon. Spear not going to be found there. Bubble also going to go wide. He's going to be available as Kanna does find himself a stun onto Dudu. And look, yeah, now the Renekton's going to have a real struggle here in this lane, and he's going to continue to do so as the Grand Skyfall gets Effort that kill.
See that Haru's just going to have to take the reins on holding this, but he's going to get burst.
Yeah. Half health just from one combo. As now Faker finds the bubble onto Haru. Doesn't even make it into the base gate. He's very dead. Faker trying to redeem himself here. 22 minutes into this game. Not a lot of damage out of him. Runons is complete here for Viper. As Faker going to have to go golden as the depth charge was heading towards him. In goes Haru, looking for the kickback, and it is on to Faker. Viper should be able to help take down that kill. Is now Cuz trying to run for the hills. They are respecting Kanna, as you can see, but Teddy's free hitting, and Dudu's just walking at him. Nothing he can really do. The Pantheon's going to be taken down, though, and Lahens goes golden. Viper chasing after Kanna, who gets over the ward. Moonlight Vigil not going to find him. There's a control ward, but unable to get over. As you can see, Viper didn't want to waste his flash. A lot of value there from the Sky Strike out of Cuz. This should be Humble Life able to grab their first Infernal Drake. And Haru alive this time, able to secure it. Effort and Faker fall. Only Dudu going to be sacrificed as, okay, in goes Cuz to try and grab that kill. Miru's going to be the first one to be taken down as Viper has the onslaught, but he doesn't have the health bar. And the huge bear is going to pop off. Kanna jumps on top of the Lee Sin, and Faker launches in from the side. He'll have a lot of sparkles to deliver to Lahens. And now T1 might be able to win the game.
Yeah, I mean, there's 20 seconds, 25 seconds here. Only Dudu is available. So I think he just has to try to get into the back line and take out the minions and somehow not die. Not going to be an easy feat for him.
Yeah, he wants to kill the minion wave, as you can see. He picked up a stopwatch, but there are still some creeps alive. And T1 grabbed the aggro. They're going to try and keep these creeps alive. They're not even going to have to worry about it. Arrow's going to secure Miru in his fountain, and T1 return in kind.
Karma 이게 막 이거 나 뒷태분 다이가
따라와줘 바텀으로 가면 끝나. 게임 끝내자. 바텀 가자.
내가 할게 이거.
게임 끝난다. 바텀 가면. 게임 끝났다 이거.
풀 좀 할게.
바텀으로 다 뭉쳐. 끝났어 이거.
이거 레넥 높여 풀테크 좀.
Tried to push back to get Miru out of the lane. Then Cuz comes in and tries to push to punish the back of Miru. And then Haru's there again. He's able to hold it, and the TP comes in as ooh.
Oh dear. That's gonna be the Death Grasp coming forward, and now it's up to Haru. He's gonna flash in. Hasn't even thrown an axe yet, as there's the flash out. Some shenanigans may unfold as Haru. That's another axe miss. That's a hookshot success. And Kanna just wanders out casually.
That's embarrassing. Oh.
Spotted. They could try to dive here.
Yeah, full health bar here for Haru. Kanna, not a lot of mana. He should be dead. As the Obliterate comes in, Dudu secures the assist, and that is First Blood. So finally, they're able to get that one done.
Done there as a fight in the mid lane.
Yep, Miru trying to get out. Hextech sweep. Going to grab an extra kill here for Kanna. Indic is not doing so well, as here's the Flash Facebreaker. Into the Showstopper. And it works pretty nicely as Miru does the most that he can, but that's sweet. But because of the Karthus factor, T1 don't really care about it at all as our Faker moves on over towards Miru. There's a Showstopper, and now the Sylas has to deal with three people and he won't be able to. Karthus delivered that kill very, very easily.
Pick up the first couple of Drakes, it will be Ocean Soul this time around.
Well, there's the Death Realm. Immediate teleport in here from Hanwar as Dudu's trying to hold on to his life. Does have his W, but there's Requiem. Hextech Ultimatum comes down immediately. It's a trade of kills as Cuz gets another one. 100% worth for T1. And yeah, this was pretty self-explanatory as Dudu is going to be dead. Sometimes you shouldn't eat Skittles. It could be bad for you.
Yeah.
Not going to proc onto Dudu there. As Viper teleports into the mid lane, they're looking for Teddy. Axe doesn't quite have that range as Teddy picks up the W. There's the flashes coming out from everyone. Depth Charge is going to connect. Dredge Line will be available. Teddy has no flash, and that is a dead misfortune. And another buff to be stolen here from Hanwar. They're not out of this one just yet as Effort looking to come in. Finds a Dredge Line onto Haru. Wall of Pain, there's the Ragnarok as now Miru tries to eat some of the aggro and unfortunately has a little bit of a bigger bite than he wanted. And at least one of the abilities landed. Faker in trouble, as Tempered Fate avoided there pretty nicely. He is ghosting around. Still has the flash available, by the way. There are so many shows being stopped. Someone continue the show! As Faker at 200, just chopping through the grit. Gonna be absolutely fine. There's the magical journey, and an abduct onto Cuz as well. Down to about half effort. Now finds himself in amongst three members. There is a magical journey as there's a Requiem. Miru trying to grab that health back. The MF going to be able to take him down. Exhaust as Lahend is just meep slapping him, trying to grab those kills. But Kanna's going to be able to grab the bar. Oh. Haru should be dead as well. A double for the Camille, and that's disastrous news here for Hanwar, who did manage to grab a couple of kills, but they are traded back in kind, plus an extra one for T1. You can see Hanwar are looking for a fight here. So we'll see who's going to be Death Realmed this time around. This is Ocean Soul Point, so Hanwha understand that they have to fight for it. Smite can be removed from the team fight if the Mordekaiser wants to try and battle with it, as Miru picks up a Depth Charge, as Faker looking for the backline. There's the Showstopper onto Lahend, so they grab that kill very early. Dudu trying to cycle through that W as he's brought Cuz out of the team fight. Will the Obliterates be there? The answer's no, as T1 are just way too strong at this point in time. Karthus or no Karthus, it doesn't matter. And now they have an Ocean Soul. This game's over. Since then, you know, Miru's stepped up. Not this game, but recently, as Kanna's just gonna walk back into the Hextech Ultimatum of Miru. Throws his own out, but it's not going to be enough. And yes, you killed the Camille, but you lost two inner turrets. And possibly your Mordekaiser as well, as there's a Showstopper. Dudu taking a lot of damage here from Faker, who is just so tanky. He's got a Trinity Course.
I think they just end up giving this kill over to Karthus. Maybe not even on purpose.
He's probably dead again, as Requiem is a button that was pressed. Miru goes gold. As he's probably just going to be taken down here. Tempered Fate is going to buy a little bit of extra time, as there is a lot of gold in here, but it's
mostly for T1 to join their very full trophy case that they already have for themselves. A 10,000 gold lead, Monkey off the back of T1 here as it's a red side victory up against Humble Life, and it wasn't close, guys. This cup has got so damn fed. A brilliant example of what 5th pick on red side can be. It was amazing what T1 managed to do with it this time around. It was a brilliant draft. And yes, Humble Life certainly drafted into it, but this is what happens.
我这里离过啊，在两个内的，两个内的，啊，TJ到一个，我拉普都亏啊，TJ啊，TJ，哇，一级不离死啊，我拉普都亏，哎，进一半一段，两级中，有三步的吧？啊，我能够掏金，但我能够把波恩的掏金，但我能够，前面那个打，那你知道没？我拉普都亏，掏中解救，苍梦啊，啊，还有啥呢？还有那空杆那个，还有那个波装那家还有啥呢？啊，不要一个，那个波装那家还有啥呢？不要，汤威，汤威啊，不要不给，好的，好。